Hillary Clinton's team deleted emails that were subpoenaed by the FBI. You have these discussions all the time about what exact laws was Hillary supposed to have broke. The investigation into her was having a private server, the legalities of that. The laws are very shady. James Comey ends up saying that she can't be charged because she didn't have intent to break the law, things of that nature. So Hillary supporters use this as a reason to say, it was all a witch hunt. No reasonable prosecutor would have prosecuted her. And it's hard to look into the law and find out exactly what's going on. But I'm going to break it down real simple for you. The real crime, the easiest crime that her team committed, was destroying evidence that was subpoenaed by the FBI. Now imagine this. Let's say your local police, or God forbid the FBI, are charging you with a crime and they say, hey, you're going to have to turn over your cell phone. We're subpoenaing your cell phone to see the messages on it. 3 weeks after you get that subpoena, you decide to destroy your cell phone. Do you really think that you're not going to jail immediately? Of course you're going to be. No one would get away with that. What possible excuse could you have for doing this? Well, Hillary's team's excuse was, oh, it's cool. We had these emails set aside and we planned for months to delete them anyways. And the FBI actually bought that excuse. It is absolutely absurd. Now, people defending her will say, well, technically, though, if you look at the law, it says in order to break the law for destroying evidence, you had to intend to destroy it for the purpose of for basically trying to help your case. Well, one, that's an absurd stance, because if the FBI requests something and you hold on to it for 3 weeks and then delete it, it proves that you intended to delete it so that they couldn't have it. It doesn't matter what your motivations were. That was your intent. But secondly, in this case, that's not going to matter. Hillary hires this IT guy named Paul Combetta. He goes on a website called Reddit the night before he ends up deleting all these emails, and he's asking people for help on how he could remove, and I'm quoting now, a very VIP's name from email exchanges. Basically, what this means is there's a bunch of emails that Hillary doesn't want the FBI seeing with her name attached to it, maybe with like five other people's names. So it could be Hillary, her assistant, Human Abedin, her campaign manager, John Podesta. Well, her tech guy's trying to get her name taken off these emails, because if her name's not on the emails, then the FBI has no reason to look at them, because the warrants to look at emails for Hillary Clinton. Unfortunately, he can't get any help. He doesn't find out how to take her name off it. So then, the very next day, coincidentally, he happens to delete these emails. This proves that the story of, oh, we had these emails set aside for months and we're going to delete them, so our bad, it's total nonsense. If you were going to delete the emails anyways, why would you try to make small adjustments taking some person's name off them? It's an absolutely absurd story. It is cut and dry, and yet the FBI allowed this to go on. This is proof that the FBI did not want to charge Hillary, and we see that in all kinds of other places. When you start to look at the text messages from the FBI agents, the fact that James Comey is writing exonerating letters months before the investigation into her is over, or before he interviewed her, it is clear they were doing everything in their power to not charge her with a crime. This is just the clearest example of it. So the next time someone asks, oh, well, someone tries to say, like, she didn't have intent, she didn't break the crime, forget about the server. The clearest crime broke was her team destroyed subpoenaed evidence and no one was charged for it. Just shows how corrupt and biased the FBI was in this investigation.